Yo, what's up, guys? So the Scots came out a few days ago, and we wanted to listen to all the music that came out on Friday. But today, I think it's Monday morning, I guess. Can't even keep track of the days anymore. And we decided we're gonna listen to Juice WRLD's Righteous. I mean, obviously it took a little bit to listen to him after everything that has happened after his passing, but today we're gonna listen to Righteous and watch the video.
I mean, that's basically it. Yeah, I've been looking forward to hearing some of his music for a while, because I think that, like, his family was stating that it was kind of like, it was hard trying to maneuver like how to release it, because they didn't feel like it was right up until this point. So definitely been looking forward to listening to some new Juice WRLD. With that being said, I guess let's get into it.
Thank you guys for watching. Put in the comments below what you want us to review next. Hit the like and sub button. We're 5 away from 1,000 as we speak. And all you Juice WRLD fans, continue to support him and his music, and comment what you review next. Juice WRLD, Righteous, let's get into it. So, I mean, we kind of saw this go a few ways. So I know Mac Miller's, I don't want to speak too out of proportion, out of pocket, but Mac Miller's posthumous album got, I liked it better than Swimming. Circles was better than Swimming, in my opinion. I don't know about you guys. And X's question mark album was, it was great. And then every album he dropped after that, like Bad Vibes Forever and whatnot, I don't even know if that was what it was called, but I mean, that just goes to show that we don't even know what the album is called. I was a big X listener before his passing, and I should have continued that, but obviously, like, I don't know. It feels different. And even Pop Smoke, but hopefully Pop Smoke's, I know Pop Smoke had a lot in the vault, so hopefully Juice WRLD has, that's crazy that they made a video for this, but we're gonna watch it with the video too. Crazy, it started like above the clouds. I like Gucci suit, I'm feeling righteous. Yeah, I know that the truth is hard to digest. Yeah. Cody running over on my nightstand. Taking medicine to fix all of the damage. My anxiety. This song, it literally sounds like it could have been an album single. Like, it sounds so finished and, like, so, like, engineered, like, perfectly. Like, it's crazy. It sounds, like, ready for an album. It's nuts. It's dope. Oh, yeah. This is a really well-made video. Damn. Those are like really, really well made video and shit. Well, I mean, that was Righteous by Juice WRLD. Dude, that was really, really, really well made. The animation was dope. Everything was sweet. I like how they, you know, like, it felt like he was, like, right there with you. Dude, it's so hot in this room. Holy shit.
It's not at all.
I'm wearing a hoodie. That's probably why. But it literally feels like he's right there. And, you know, like, the whole, like, animation they did just to show like he was like still like watching over, but kind of like in the distance, was so cool. This is definitely like, I don't know, it sounds better than half of his last album. What was it called? Death Race For Love?
Death Race, yeah, that's what it's called, I think.
So those are my thoughts on it. For real, crazy, crazy good track. Seriously good track.
I just like the melodies in general. I liked how the video was made. I liked how they used like all the footage. It was almost as if they were like filming, like they were like documenting his, like they were filming a documentary or something, I don't know. They had a lot of footage. I love that. I also I love the animation style too. But most importantly, I love the song. Like he said earlier, it sounded like a finished song that could have been used for an album. But yeah, I really love the melodies of the songs, love the beat, love the lyrics.
And the craziest part is song. Craziest part is speaking about Juice WRLD in general, you know, like there's so many artists and people who are like, when they make their art, it's so like unique and creative towards. Craziest thing about you know, artists and their art, you know, when The Weeknd made My Dear Melancholy, I almost said melancholy, wow. When The Weeknd made My Dear Melancholy, you know, he was definitely hurting, and you know, Privilege was talking about like how he's taking two red pills to take the blues away, and like clearly like a bunch of Juice WRLD's, you know, music was to like a cry out for help. And that's sometimes when artists like like when they're hurt the most, they make the best music, and for to us it's just pleasure, but to them it's actually pain. So I mean, we got to be more mindful of that going forward. And this is just an example. I mean, Juice WRLD was literally like what, 20, 21 years old?
Yeah.
And I mean, just going forward, that's my little rant. Can't lose more, for real. This year's been shitty enough as is. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Like, subscribe, comment what we should review next. I'm Irish.
I'm Furs.
Thank you guys for watching. Peace.